How are you, ma'am?
I'm doing fine, thank you. How are you?
I am fine, ma'am.
Today what I'll do is that we'll hold a short grammar lesson. Does it sound good to you?
That's also good, ma'am.
Okay. So today we are going to be discussing in grammar. There are two phrases. One is called wish and the second one is called if only. Have you heard of it?
Wish, W-I-S-H.
Yes. Wish and if only. There are these two phrases which are used frequently in grammar.
Okay.
We use it when we speak.
Mm-hmm.
So, can you tell me when do we use wish and when do we use if only?
So, if wish, I can use like I wish to do this one. I wish to help him, but because of his nature, I didn't help him. I wish I can help you with this. So, I wish means, you're right? Am I right or wrong?
Yes, okay. And if only, when do we use if only?
So, if only is going to use is particularly for condition.
Okay, say for example.
So, I can help you if only if you will help me. For yeah.
Okay, so, that can be one. Okay, so what else?
If only we can use like... you will get some discount if only if you have that particular credit card, if you have.
Okay. So, basically, we don't say you will get discount if only you have that credit card. So, if only and wish. So, the basic difference between them, wish is a desire.
Mm-hmm.
When you are expressing a desire, you say, I wish.
Mm-hmm.
But if only is mainly used when we are expressing regret. So, if only I did not lose her phone, I would have called her.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? If only if I had. So, I'm regretting the fact that I have lost her phone and I'm unable to call her. So, if only is mainly used to express a regret.
Okay.
Wish and only. So you say, I wish to do this.
Mm-hmm.
That is, if you are weighing the scale, mm-hmm. on a scale, if you are weighing the level of your desire,
mm-hmm.
I wish to do this, maybe it will fall on a scale of 1 to 10, it will probably fall on 7.
Mm-hmm.
But if you say, if only I could do this,
mm-hmm.
if only if I could do this, that scale goes up. It means you have a very strong desire, but something is stopping you from doing it.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
I wish to eat ice cream.
Mm-hmm.
I wish to eat an ice cream. It's a wish. Mm. If only I could eat an ice cream. If only I could eat an ice cream. I'm putting much more stress. It is much more... on a scale of wishes, if we are matching, if only is a higher scale.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So that is something which we really have to keep in mind when we are talking about wish and if only.
Mm-hmm.
Another thing which we see is we can use wish and if only, we can use it in present or in past mm-hmm. form. So I can say, I wish to have a car. I wish I had a car.
Mm-hmm.
If only I can drive. If only I could drive. So past, present, in both situations, we can use if only and wish.
So as I said, that we can use that condition.
It's not exactly more of a condition. It is more of a... feeling of it's a strength of feeling.
Mm-hmm.
So there is something known as if only and only something known as only if. So what you said was you will get this discount
only if.
We don't say if only you have this credit card, we say only if. So there are two different conditions here. One is if only and one is only if. Only if means, okay, that is where your condition clause
comes. Okay, that's fine.
Only if is condition. But if only is not a condition. If only is a feeling. It's a feeling of stress. It's a strong feeling.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. I got it.
Did you get it? So,
yeah.
Can you give me an example with if only?
So, if only, still I am not getting properly exact. If only, where I can use, still I am not getting. I wish I can understand. I wish I had a car. I wish.
Yes.
I wish I had completed my graduation. I wish I had talked with my friends.
Yes. So say for example, I take this example of I wish I could talk with my friends.
Okay. I wish I could talk with my friends. Yeah.
Okay. We have the sentence here. I wish we could talk with my. Okay. Wait. Hang on a second. Let me share my screen with you. So let's see if I can share a blank. Okay. Wow. There's no whiteboard here. Okay. Hang on a second. Let me open a Word document and let me share my screen with you. Okay. Okay, can you see my this page?
Yes,
okay.
Yes, I can
so
see.
Wish says, if I increase the font here, so Wish says, I wish I could talk with my friends. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
This is your wish.
Okay.
When you're using the if only condition, it is like, if only I had a mobile phone.
Mm-hmm.
You can say, if I had their number,
mm-hmm.
I could talk to my friends. Or if only I have, you say, this is, we have said it in past.
Past.
If I wish I could talk with my friends, if only is in the, and we have convert, we have, you know, put the sentence with if only, and we have said,
so, okay.
We have.
Okay. Yes.
Now, now can you get the difference between if only and I wish?
Yes. I wish means I want to do something. If only, if this thing was there with me, I will do something else.
Exactly. If only we use the condition of if only when we are expressing a regret.
Regret, yeah.
Yes. I have a wish to do something, but I'm unable to do that. Why? Because I lack something.
Mm-hmm.
I don't have that.
Okay.
I wish to go on a long journey.
Mm-hmm.
I wish to go on a long vacation. I wish to go to, say for example, I wish to go to Pune.
Mm-hmm.
If only the flights were available, I wish I could go to, I could go to Pune.
Mm-hmm.
So if only the flights were available, I could have gone to Pune.
Mm-hmm.
So because something is not happening, I can't do something.
Mm-hmm.
So if only is that regret.
Okay, and now I understand what is the if only. Yeah. So if only where we can use, like if only I had the money, I would have helped him.
Exactly. If only I had the money, I would have helped him. I wish I could help him.
I wish I could help. Yes, I would
help
have.
Him. But if you are using the if only condition, you would have said, if only I had the money, I could have helped him.
Yes, I could have helped him. Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is it clear?
Yes. Completely
okay.
Clear. Yeah.
Yeah. Now, when we look at the sentence structure,
mm-hmm.
how we form the sentence.
Mm-hmm.
So, when we are talking about in present,
mm-hmm.
so when we are talking about in present with wish, the sentence structure is always subject plus wish or if only,
mm-hmm.
and we use the past form of verb.
Okay, third form.
Past form.
Past
so the past, yeah. So, let's take this. I wish I could talk with my friends. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So, the helping verb here is, so this is can, actually.
So, means I can understand. The second condition was third form.
Past, present, future. It's a second form. The past form of verb. The simple past form of the verb.
Yeah, past form of the verb, yeah.
Okay? So when you are constructing a sentence, always remember this is your construction rule. This is for when you are talking about in present, not in past. When you are talking about in present.
Your screen is not visible. Did you?
Oh, I'm sorry. Hang on a second. Okay, I wasn't sharing my screen. That's why it wasn't visible. Oh, where did it go? Wait. So, okay, something is not allowing me to share my screen. So what I'll do is
first stop the screen and then this will do.
Yeah, I've already stopped sharing it. I don't know why it's not allowing me to share. Okay, there you are. Now it's done. So,
yes,
say for example, if I take this sentence. So here it would be subject plus wish plus could. So could is the past simple past form of the verb can.
Yes.
Okay. Could plus we have, so could is the verb here. Okay. Plus we have the modifier. The modifier is the extended sentence. So these extended sentences are called modifiers.
Okay.
Okay. So whenever we are for present, so whenever we are talking about it, it is always, I wish I could talk with my friends.
Okay, that's good.
Other one, I wish she didn't have to leave town. Okay. Again, can you tell me what is the what is the sentence construction here?
This is a past tense.
Yes. But then can you tell me, I wish she didn't have to leave town. Am I talking about something which happened in the past, or am I talking about something which is happening in the present?
I wish she didn't have to leave town. So
am I describing an event which is happening in the present?
No, past.
No, it's present. I wish she didn't have to leave town.
I wish she didn't leave. Means we are talking in the recently we are talking, I mean now we are talking, but the thing we are talking at the past.
Yes, but we are talking now, we are talking in the present.
Yeah, exactly.
So whenever you're talking about in the present, so it is always subject plus wish or if only, whichever you're using, plus the simple past form of the verb. So do, the simple past form is the did.
Okay, got it.
Okay, so that is how we form sentences when we are talking about in present. So can you give me an example of a present sentence using if only and wish? One sentence with wish and one sentence with if only.
So I wish he didn't reach in his home.
He didn't reach his home?
Yeah.
Okay, so you don't say I wish he didn't reach in his home. You say I wish he didn't reach his home.
Didn't.
It's called didn't.
Didn't.
Or the best way to say it, I wish he did not reach home.
Yeah, I wish he did not reach his home.
Reach his home. Okay. Now, can you give me a sentence with if only? Can you change this sentence to if only?
So, if only. So, if only he had reached his home when he. If only he had reached his home, if he find some auto rickshaw.
No, so you are going into past again over here. So what you can say is, if only he reached his home.
Okay, the
If
finish.
only, yeah, if only he reached his home, we could have had a chat, or if only he reached his home, we could have done this. If only he did not reach his home, we could have, we could have continued with our discussion. Okay, so that is how we construct sentences using if only and wish when we are talking about present. In the present, incidents which has happened in the present. When we are talking about that is how we construct sentences. Now let look at if we are talking about incidents which has happened in the past. We are using the wish and or if only condition, but we are talking about something which has happened in the past. Okay, so can you give me an example of a sentence which has happened in the past?
So I wish I wish if I if I wish I could purchase the car so that we have we okay. Past this combination is very different. Let me try again.
Yes,
So
please do.
I wish if I could I wish if I could drive. Okay, can I use if also?
No, you cannot use if only and wish together. Either one combination you have to use.
I wish I could drive the car.
We are talking past. I wish I could drive the car is present. An incident which is happening present. The wish is in the present. This you are saying about something which has happened in the past. I wish I could have driven the car.
Could also past tense, no ma'am?
Yes, I could have. Could here is the helping verb. So we are using the modal verb could here.
Oh, okay, this is a verb here. So I wish I could have driven the car if okay, finish.
Yeah, I wish I could have driven the car. So, let's look at how sentences are formed in the past tense with the. So, I wish I could have driven the car. Okay, this is past. So, when we are talking about the past, it is always, you must remember, the verb which is used is the past perfect form of verb. Have driven, the past perfect. I wish I could have driven the car. I wish they hadn't called me. I wish she hadn't eaten a bowl of ice cream. So we always use the past perfect. Same with if only.
So, yeah.
So,
So if
in,
only
yeah.
if only they could have driven the car.
If only they could have driven the car. Very good.
So we can make like if only
If only I could have driven the
they
car.
if only they could have no if only they would have bought the car.
Yes, we can say. Okay. So that is how the constructions are formed with if only and with wish. Is it clear?
Yes, completely clear, ma'am.
Completely clear? Okay.
Yes.
So what I want you to do is, we have the next 10 minutes of the time that we have. I want you to describe an event in your life using I wish and if only. A combination of I wish and if only. An event in your life. You can even make it up. I don't mind.
Okay, yeah. So If I wish I had learned English so that I can
I had learned English.
I had learned English so that I can easily so that I can comment okay. So past to now.
No, okay. So it's now. It's happening. I wish I had learned English.
So that I can communicate with my friends.
Very good. Okay. Go on. Continue.
And if only if I had mobile
in okay, my if only I had a mobile
if I,
a
if,
mobile so you need to give an article before so an object
if only I had mobile a mobile if I only if I had a mobile I could have called with my I could have called with my parents
I could have called with my parents I could have called my parents. I could have called my parents.
Called my parents. Yes.
Okay. Go on.
Yeah. So if only like my if only my brother have if only my brother didn't purchase the car. He will not suffer that problem, like accident will not happen.
Okay, so in that case you say if only my brother hadn't purchased the car he wouldn't have had the accident. So
yeah,
if only my brother hadn't purchased the car, he
wouldn't
have had the accident. Okay. What is wouldn't and hadn't? What is it actually? If I ask you, so if I ask you that I don't understand hadn't, so what do you mean by hadn't?
In future, that was there. Means that is,
No. Forget about future. Just the word hadn't. I don't understand hadn't. What does hadn't mean?
Tha. Nahi tha. That we can call is.
Ha, theek hai, bhai. Nahi tha. In English, what does it mean?
Ha, okay. Was not happen.
No. Hadn't is had plus not. Had not.
Had not. Oh, yeah. Had not, yeah.
Had not. Hadn't is had plus not. So it's a contraction which has been used.
Yeah, hadn't. Yeah.
Didn't, hadn't, wouldn't. Hadn't. These are contractions.
Contraction, yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Okay. So if only my brother hadn't purchased the car, he wouldn't have had the accident. Mm-hmm. Another thing always keep in mind, if only and wish, they are always in the beginning of the sentence.
Oh, okay. Uh-huh.
So, we start the sentence with, if only I hadn't done this, this would still have been there.
This would have been still there.
Okay. We don't say, this would still have been there if only I hadn't done this. We say it, if only I hadn't done this, this would still have been there.
Mm.
Okay. Okay. Mm-hmm. Go on. Continue.
So, if only that car was not, that cat was not passed my way, I wouldn't have suffered that problem.
Okay. Repeat again.
Okay. If only that cat.
It's not cat, it's cat.
Kate.
Cat. Ah.
Cat.
Cat. Cat.
Cat.
Ah.
Cat.
At. So how do you say eight. At?
Eight. Eight.
A says a, say a.
A.
A. Bada a. Karke. Bada. A. A nahi. A.
A.
Cat. Cat.
Cat. Cat.
Cat. Exactly.
Cat.
If only the cat had. Okay. Go on. Cat.
If only the cat was not pass. If I was not. Okay. If only the cat was not passing this way. My way, that accident was not happen.
Completely wrong. Okay. You say it, if only the cat had not crossed my way.
Cross my way?
Cat doesn't pass your way. Cat crosses your way.
Uh-huh. Okay.
Okay. If only the cat had not crossed my way, then complete the sentence.
That accident was not happen.
Would not have happened.
Would not have happened.
Would not. We are using would not have happened.
Yeah.
So have. If we are using had not, we will use would not.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Go on. Another with a wish.
Okay. So my God, I wish. Okay. I wish I could have worked hard. I wish I could have done hard work so that I would have placed in good company.
Okay. I wish I could have worked hard. I would have done hard work completely incorrect. You say, I wish I could have worked hard.
Work hard?
No, done in the between. I wish I could have worked hard.
Worked hard.
Then I would have been placed in a good company.
So that.
Then. So
yeah.
We are using the condition then here.
Yeah.
So then. What we are doing, there are two sentences. I wish I could have worked hard. And the second is, I would have been placed in a good company. Now, when we are joining these two sentences, one condition is dependent on the other condition. So your placement in the good company is dependent on your working hard. Isn't it?
This is your first condition. Yeah.
Yeah. So this is your first condition. So since this is your first condition, you have to use the comparison then. So if I did this, only then this would have happened.
This would have happened. Yeah. Okay. I got
okay.
it. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Right, one more sentence. We have one, I think, 2 more minutes time.
I wish if only. If only. If only I had the bottle of water.
Bottle of water.
Mm-hmm.
If only I had a bottle, not the bottle, a bottle, one bottle you want. You if just only, don't want. Yeah.
If only I had bottle of water.
If only I had a bottle of water.
I would have drink it.
Drunk it.
Drunk it.
Drink is again present. If only I had a bottle of water, I would have drunk it. So you are talking about past here.
I wish, now I have not to talk with present, but it will go to the past. I wish I didn't drink water. I can't do in past tense.
I wish I drank water.
I wish I drank water.
You can say that. I wish I drank water.
But there is no condition after there.
It's just a wish you're saying. I wish I could drink water.
Okay. I wish I drank water. Okay. I wish I drank water. Okay. Okay. Fine.
Okay.
Okay.
If you had drunk water. So we are using the past perfect, had drunk.
So if only we need to use with had.
So whenever we are talking, remember one thing. So when you are using in present, when we are talking in present, I wish I could drink water. I wish I could do something. When you are talking about in present, the verb we are using is simple past form.
Okay, understand.
Okay.
Okay.
Keep it in your mind.
Okay.
When we are talking about past.
Past.
Then no matter whether we are using if wish, I wish or if only, the verb is always in the past perfect form.
Okay,
These are
understand.
the two rules you need to just keep in mind.
Okay, understand.
Automatically, your the sentence will be correct.
Okay.
And so that's it.
Okay, fine. Now I understand completely.
Okay, so how did you like your lesson today?
Madam, it's amazing, man. Now I can tell you that I had put it 100% focus in this thing, because focus is very important. Okay. Sometimes I will go in my way. So some new things, when we learn something, so must be the focus will be there in 30 minutes, complete 30 minutes.
Okay.
So anyhow, I had learned good things from today.
Okay. So what I want you to do, when is our next class?
Mm-hmm.
So when do you want to have your next class? Saturday, Sundays, I don't teach. I can teach again on Monday.
Oh, Monday, no problem, ma'am.
Okay, so Monday.
Monday, can we have it evening?
Evening, what time?
Evening, 7.